I am Cylindrica. Today in this video we are going to discuss about the phylum Tenophora, right? So this Tenophora they are commonly called as Coon Jellies. So ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವೇನ್ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಕೂನ್ ಜೆಲ್ಲೀಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಸೊ ಯಾಕಂತ ಅದನ್ನ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ 8 ರೋಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೂನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಕೂನ್ ಜೆಲ್ಲೀಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಮರೈನ್ ಸೊ ಆಸ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ನೋ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟೈಟ್ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಟಿನೋಫೋರಾ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಮರೈನ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್ ದೇರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟೈಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮರೈನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ They show tissue level of organization. In these animals, okay, Tenophora nalli innu organs develop agila because there is a tissue. Whole complete body is made up of tissue. Clear? So, illi yaade reethi adanta organs develop agila. Okay, complete body enadu, it is made up of tissue and hence particular tissue is having a particular function. Okay, so ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಇರೋದು ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಲಿಂತ್ರ ಈ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಗ ಅಂಡ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯಾದಂತಹ ಆರ್ಗನ್ ಇರದ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ನೂವರೆಗೂ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಎನಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ರೈಟ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ರೇಡಿಯಲ್ ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿಪ್ಲೋಬ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ So, the word radial symmetry literally means when you cut the body into central axis. So, body na mein central axis mein tra cut maadadaga, nim yeen sigutte, yard equal half sigutte, right? So, yard equal half sikkaga na adana yeen karithini radial symmetry. Okay, it means if it is a body, so this is a center. If you cut like this, you will get two equal halves. If you cut like this, then also you will get two equal halves. Like this, then also you will get two equal halves. So that is what the animal's body is show cylindrical symmetry. That means you cut into the central axis of the body, you will get two equal halves. That is radial symmetry. Even the animal is diploblastic. That means it is having two layers. So outer layer in the ectoderm and inner layer in the endoderm. Okay, so here the middle layer is upside. So animal the embryonic stage nalli. Okay, the animal the embryonic stage nalli. Yerad layer na nam observe martivi. Yavadappa adu outer ectoderm and inner endoderm. So two layers are present. Hence we call it as diploblastic. Next body bears 8 rows of ciliary comb plates which are present externally. So as you all know, so here, so see, this is a body. It is a body of an animal. So which is having externally like externally it has irutte okay enadu 8 ciliary comb mantra gottala hanige bachanike bachanike kai irutte namdu ee riti right ee tara namdu bachanike irutte comb okay so adhe tara body melagade ee tara 8 comb plates irutte okay so this 8 comb plates yaakirutte yedakbekiri plates. What is the main function of this 8 comb plates? Nothing but it helps in locomotion. 8 ciliary comb plates. So these are the cilias. Okay. So ciliary comb plate. ಈ ತರ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಹಣಿಗೆ ಬಾಚಣಿಕೆ ಹೇಗೆ ಕಡ್ಡಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಸಣ್ಣ ಸಣ್ಣ ಕಡ್ಡಿ ಇರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ಆ ತರ 8 ಇನ್ನದ comb ciliary comb plates cilias will be there okay cilias will be there and that helps for the locomotion of the organism clear hence adike ipadite helidini body bears 8 rows of ciliary comb plates that is present externally at the outside the body okay so these comb plates they are present outside the body and that helps in locomotion ಇದು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಗೆ locomotion ಗೆ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಡೈಜೆಷನ್ ಈಸ್ intracellular or extracellular? Both. Intracellular lentrum digestion agutte and extracellular lentrum digestion agutte. What it means? It means digestion occurs within the cell. If the digestion is occurring within the cell, cell olagade inadru digestion aagta ide andre adanna na enu kirithini intracellular. If the digestion occurs outside the cell, then it is called as extracellular. That means illi in case of Ctenophora, digestion is both intracellular and extracellular. So digestion ki nakuda within the cell aagutha, outside the cell aagutha. So hence I call it as the digestion is intracellular and extracellular, right? So next in the bioluminescence property, as the word bio, luminescence, and that means light. The animal has capacity to emit the light. So ee phylum nalli ee animals bartavala, they are having capacity to emit the light, hence I call them as bioluminescence property. Bioluminescence property means what here? The animals having capacity to produce light or to emit light. Okay, next hermoprodite. So hermoprodite andre enile, here the sexes are not separate. Male bere, female bere, ee tara irodilla. So sexes are not separate. Both the sexes are present in a single individual. Male and female, both the sexes are present in a single individual. Hence, I call them as hermaphrodite. It means the sexes are present. Both the sexes, that is male reproductive structure and female reproductive structure, both of them, they are present in a single organism. Hence, I call them as hermaphrodite. Reproduction is sexual. Here, I tell that, that is reproduction is sexually type. It means the fusion of gametes takes place. Male produces the gamete and even the female also produces the gamete. Both the gametes fuses. Hence, I call that reproduction is sexual type. That means fusion of gametes takes place. Next, fertilization is external. What it means external? The fusion of male and female gametes takes place outside the body. Okay. And fertilization process in the body. It means what here? That means fusion of male and female gamete that takes place outside the body. Hence, I call it as fertilization is external. It means it is taking outside the body. Clear? Next, development is indirect. What it means? Development is indirect. Really, it is nothing but here directly end ones develop. Here, zygote aagtakshana in develop aagutha, there are many larval stages, and after the larval stages, the adult is going to form. Hence, the development is indirect. Indirect means what here? That means there is no formation of young ones. Young ones directly produce aagutha. Firstly, in form after the larval stages, there are many larval stages. After that larvae, the young ones will develop. That larvae changes into young ones. Hence, the development is indirect. Clear? So, development in the indirect. Example of this phylum are, that is Ctenophora, Ctenophlena, Cleobranchia. So, these are the examples of phylum Ctenophora. Because the body bears 8 rows of ciliary combs. Hence, we call it as comb jellies. Because body is completely moist. Okay, body is completely moist, slippery. Hence, I call it as a comb jellies. Because externally, body is having 8 rows of ciliary combs and it is very slippery. Hence, I call it as a comb jellies. Hence, it is commonly called as comb jellies. Right? I hope you all have understood the characteristics of the phylum Tenopura. So in this phylum, they may ask for 1 mark. What is bioluminescence? Right? So bioluminescence andre enu anta kelabodu athava prominent feature of this phylum kelabodu. So the most prominent or important feature of this phylum is bioluminescence property, and the body bears 8 rows of ciliary comb plates. So these two are the most important and peculiar point of this phylum, right? So I hope you have understood this phylum. So next we will move to the next phylum, that is phylum Platyhelminthes. So dear students, we will discuss about the phylum Platyhelminthes now, right? So Platyhelminthes are called commonly called as flatworms. Why they are called as flatworms? Because the body of the worms are dorsoventrally flattened. That means this is a dorsally, uppermost portion, ventrally, lowermost portion. So they are flattened. Okay? So it is purilla. They are dorsoventrally flattened, like paper like. Okay? So think this is a book. So it is a dorsoventrally flattened. Okay? If I do the same book like this, is this a dorsoventrally flattened? See here? No. If like this, it is a dorsoventrally flattened. Like, so the flatworms are dorsoventrally flattened, hence they are called as flatworms. Flatworms. Because they are dorsoventrally flattened. Next, they are endoparasite. What is the term endoparasite? That means they are present inside the body and they are parasite. Parasite and really, that means they are present inside the body and they are harming our body. Parasite means what here? One which harms. Clear? So he works in the body, not only in human being but also in the other animals. Clear? So these worms, the flat worms, they are present inside the animal's body as well as in human being. Body already present into the, and it harms our body. That means it is taking shelter from our body and it is taking food from our body. Instead, it is harming our body. So that is what I call it as endoparasite. Endo means inside. Ectoparasite and means outside. The parasite which is present outside the body is called as ectoparasite. That means any parasite which is harming the body outside. So best example kodla hen. Okay, so nam tele hen barutte gotta. So the hen illada tele olagade irutada, tele melgade. So adu en maduttha nam raktana heertada and is harming us, right? Adanna nan ectoparasite anta kritivi. Whereas endoparasite andre eno, the parasite which is present inside the body and harming our body. Okay, so that is what called as endoparasite. Okay, so this endoparasite is present in case of animal irbodu athava in case of human being. Now organ level of organization is present. So illi organs form agada, so that means the tissues are grouped into organs and particular organ is having a particular function. Clear? So here the organs are developed. It means each and particular organ is having a particular function. Next, it is bilateral symmetrical. That means body is bilateral symmetrical. That means when the body is cut in the central axis, so body na central axis nalli cut madadaga, you will get two equal halves, two equal right and left halves. That is what called as bilateral symmetry. So bilateral symmetry andre eno, so body na center nalli cut madadaga namage eradu en sigutade, right and left equal half sigutade. So adakke na enu anta kelthini, bilateral symmetry. So that is called as bilateral symmetry. And they are triploblastic. So yen idu triploblastic andre, it means the body, the embryonic stage nalli, so the embryo is having 3 layers. Okay, the flatworms, the embryonic stage, they are having 3 layers. that is outer ectoderm, middle mesoderm and inner endoderm. Three germ layers are present, hence they are called as triploblastic. Three layers. Okay, and they are acoelomates. So the coelom is absent. In plateal winters, coelom is absent. Hence they are called as acoelomates. Okay, next, you know the hooks and suckers. Okay, so in hooks and suckers, so the enapa function hondre. So as I told, so these worms, they are present inside the body anta helide, right? So hagadre body olagade hege irutte idu, they are present with the help of attachment. Andra nam body attached agirtav. Okay, so yaar ikka attached agirtava, because they are having hook. Ee tara hook irutada, hook. Okay, so that hook enada, that helps in the attachment. Body nalli attached agiraga hook enada help maadutha. Whereas suckers, suckers the function, you know, it helps in sucking the blood. As I told you, endoparasite en maadutha antu helide, nam body olagade irutada, nam body olagindane aahara tintada and namga harm maadutada antu helide, right? So hagadre adu suckers edakke irutada, because it sucks the blood. Adu main food eno, blood. So it sucks the blood. Okay, so the sucker helps in sucking the blood, whereas hooks edakke help maadutada, it helps for the attachment. Attached agiraka help maadu, helps for the attachment, right? So next, digestion is incomplete. So this is, I have explained it, digestion is incomplete really, that means the digestive system is having a single opening. Okay, so complete digestive system andre eno, two opening irutada, that is mouth and anus. Incomplete andre really, that means digestion is having incomplete, really it is having single opening. Okay, so a single opening that serves the function of both mouth and anus. So mouth matu anus madonta function enadala adu single opening martada. So single opening the digestive system nalli, that serves as mouth as well as anus, hence the digestive system is incomplete, right? Excretion is through phlegm cells. In human beings, excretory organ yavudappa anta kelidre navu enu heltivi, kidney anta heltivi, right? So adhe tara in case of platyhelminthes nalli excretory structure athwa excretory organ yavudu illi, phlegm cells anthe. So this may ask for one mark. Function of phlegm cell anta kelabodu one mark ige, athwa function of hook and sucker anta kelabodu. Hook edakke help aagutade, it helps for the attachment. Nam body olagade attach aagirlikke, ಒಂದು ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಗಟ್ಟಿಯಾಗಿ ಇರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹುಕ್ಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಸಕ್ಕರೆ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಟು ಸಕ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್. ವೈಲ್ ಫ್ಲೇಮ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಇಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೀಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೀಟರಿ ಆರ್ಗನ್ ದಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೀಷನ್ ಫ್ಲೇಮ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಹರ್ಮೋಪ್ರೊಡೈಟ್. ಇದನ್ನ ನಾನು ಏನಂತ ಕರಿತೀನಿ, ಹರ್ಮೋಪ್ರೊಡೈಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀನಿ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಹರ್ಮೋಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀನಿ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸಪರೇಟ್. ಬೋತ್ ಮೇಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್. ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ದ ಸೆಕ್ಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸಪರೇಟ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಹರ್ಮೋಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೈ ಅಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಲೇ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಗೆಮೆಟ್ಸ್ ದ ರೋಲ್ ಇರಲ್ಲ, ರೈಟ್? And fertilization is internal. So fertilization is internal. Because sometimes among the platyhelminthes, majority of them are asexual kind of reproduction and some of them are sexual reproduction. So some means only few. Okay, among that, kelonis to in the male and female gametes fertilization aagutada, that is to the internal in the body. Body olagade fertilization aagutada, adukka na enu karithini, internal fertilization anta karithini. And even if the fertilization internal aadruve, development enada illi, indirect development ada, because illi sakashtu larval stage ada. Aa larval stage aadmele egg pulse enaagutada, develop aagutada. So for that reason development enada indirect. So ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮೆಜಾರಿಟಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಅಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್, ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫ್ಯೂ ಶೋಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. best example ee phylum ge yavappa andre liver fluke that is fasciola hepatica and tapeworm tinea solium so these are the example one more example that is planaria anta ide so this is planaria idu kuda platyhelminthes nalle baruthe so if you cut this planaria okay this small ಕಟ್ರನ್ನ ಪ್ಲೇನಿಯಾ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಕಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲೇನಿಯಾ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ನೀವು ಒಂದು ಪ್ಲೇನಿಯಾ 100 ಕಟ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 100 ತುಕಡಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸೊ 100 ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲೇನಿಯಾಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ರೀಜನರೇಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೈ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ ರೀಜನರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಪ್ಲೇನಿಯಾ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಹೈ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ ರೀಜನರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ You cut the planaria into 100 pieces, you will get 100 new planarias, right? So that shows asexual reproduction, right? So the end of asexual reproduction, clear? So planaria na ni 100 cuts alla, 200 cuts maadi duve, 200 new planarias in akkava develop akkava. So adhikana ayin akkana ni, it shows high regeneration capacity, and that is what called as asexual reproduction. So this is about the phylum Platyhelminthes. So in this phylum Platyhelminthes, I have discussed the general characteristics of the phylum. So they may ask for 5 marks or either they may ask for the 1 or 2 marks, that is the function of hooks, suckers and flame cells. Endoparasite andre gottaythu nige, ectoparasite nu clear madide. So endoparasite andre eno, nothing but the parasite which is present inside the body. So, ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಒನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಸೊ ಯಾವ್ದೋ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ ನಮ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಅದ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದು ನಮಗೆ ಹಾರ್ಮ್ ಮಾಡಾಕ್ತದ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾ ಏನಂತ ಕರಿತೀನಿ ಎಂಡೋಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ ಅದೇ ಯಾವ್ದೋ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ ಔಟ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಅದ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾ ಏನಂತ ಕರಿತೀನಿ ಎಕ್ಟೋಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟಿಹೆಲ್ಮಿಂಥಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟುಡೇ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ಡ್ ಟೂ ಫೈಲಮ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ Tinopora and Platyhelminthes. I hope you have understood both the phylums and its classifications and its general characteristics. And dear students, while writing the general characteristics, lastly you have to mention the examples. Clear? Okay, dear students. In the next video, we will discuss new more phylums. Thank you.